You wake up in the morning feeling great with no signs of that COVID-19 thing everyone's worried about. You decide to meet a few friends who also look and feel great with no signs of any viruses. Later that night, some of these friends attended a birthday party. Nothing bad could happen, right? Here's the problem. Though you show no symptoms, you were carrying the SARS-CoV-2 virus because the disease COVID-19 caused by that virus can take a couple of weeks before any signs show. Not only that, based on what we know today, almost 80% of infected people show very mild or even no symptoms at all. You're carrying and spreading this virus and you have no idea you're doing it. Meanwhile, because of how contagious this virus is, all three of your friends got infected from meeting you. Then they infected others at that birthday party. Some of those people then carried the virus to their friends and families, crucially to the older parents they live with at home, who are more vulnerable to this disease than you are. Without knowing, you infected hundreds of people. Most will be fine, but some will get extremely sick and might even die. You see, today the data shows that one infected person can infect at least 2 to 3 people in just 1 week, and those 2 to 3 people can infect 2 to 3 more people, and so on. There is only one way to break this chain: stay inside and don't meet anyone. What scientists call social distancing and self-quarantine. If you and your friends stayed at home, none of those people would have been infected. In some cultures, many of us live near our parents and grandparents, sometimes even under the same roof. Italian culture has similar intergenerational mingling, and we have seen just how deadly the coronavirus has been in Italy, with doctors begging the rest of the world to isolate themselves and break the chain.
Well, my suggestion is that you get prepared as soon as you can.
In some cities, people are packed together like sardines. In New York City, for example, coronavirus is spreading like a bullet train, according to its governor.
The forecaster said to me, we were looking at a freight train coming across the country. We're now looking at a bullet train.
New York's high population density makes it difficult to avoid others and isolate, but they have no choice. And we can't forget there are much more crowded places in the world where social distancing and quarantine can mean people might not be able to put food on the table. But without these measures, they could end up in a much worse situation than Italy and New York. Until there are low-cost drugs and vaccines, this might be all we can do. This chain will not break in 1 or 2 days, it'll take much longer. We can put pressure on our governments to provide food and shelter for those who are isolating. We can donate directly to them, and we can be kind when we are most scared. Today, some people living in hot countries near the equator who may be most economically vulnerable may think their heat and humidity might slow down the spread of this virus. There is a lot of research on this, and it's true that many viral diseases are seasonal, but the experts have not come to a conclusion and there is evidence in both directions. So right now, not taking action is unscientific and extremely dangerous. See, science explains the natural world and this virus has evolved naturally. That's why it's critical today to understand how it evolved and spread. This is the perfect time for us to think and understand science. Let's share that thought when we see rumors, superstition, and fake news. This is our best chance to slow down and stop this pandemic, to protect our loved ones and lives around the world. With social distancing, we can come closer together as humanity. I think we're serious about social isolating. To prevent the spread of coronavirus, we switched from filming videos to just recording these audio-only videos. Click on the subscribe button and that little bell icon to keep up with our latest expert-led videos.